Hello and welcome to my channel. If you are planning to make an investment through SBI Mutual Fund, this video is going to be quite useful for you. I'll be guiding you through the process that you need to consider before starting your investment, and why these factors plays an important role is that if you are well aware, you can avoid the risk involved in the mutual fund, you can take the right decision and start your investment journey online by yourself. So let's get on to the video. If you like the video, do hit the like button and please do not forget to subscribe to the channel. This site is sbimf.com. So if you have to invest in mutual funds and you are going to invest in any of the bank, you can just go to the mutual fund site of that bank. And similarly, I went to this site, which is www.sbimf.com. And you can see when I was confused about deciding on which scheme I should go for, I just went to this option over here, which is investment solutions. As you can see, here you can find all the schemes, the equity schemes, the debt schemes, the hybrid schemes, and you can just browse through all the schemes. If you are not very sure about which scheme you have to choose, like that it should be debt or equity, you are not much aware about the differences in those schemes, you can just click on the all schemes. And here you can have a look at what all schemes are being offered by this SBI Mutual Fund. So this would help you in getting an idea about all of the schemes being presented by this SBI Mutual Fund. And this, let me show you how it works. Okay, it's taking a little bit of time to be loaded. So we can have a look over here. See, so these are the types of mutual fund investment schemes available within SBI Mutual Fund. So it's a total number of 51 schemes, as you can see it over here. The fund nature is open-ended. So let me tell you the difference between open-ended scheme and closed-ended scheme. Open-ended is, it would be flexible. Whenever you want, you can get an exit. And closed-ended would be for a certain time period. So for a fixed time period, your money would be there. And after that time period is over, then you would be reaping whatever the benefits would be related. Then the fund category. You can choose the fund category over here, whether you want to go for the equity fund, the debt fund, the hybrid fund. I have already told about these funds in one of my videos. You can consider, you can watch my videos and subscribe to my channel to understand it in a better way. You can choose the risk level as well, whether you want low risk, whether you want moderately low, moderate risk, moderately high, high risk. So it depends on your capabilities. Some of the investors are risk averse. They want to take the minimum risk and they are they are ready to compromise with the return percentage, but they are not ready to deal with the risk involved, the higher risk involved in the equity market. So some investors are like that, while some investors are ready to go for the risk and invest to get higher returns in the future. So it depends upon your choice, what kind of risk you are looking for. So if you don't want to categorize over here, you can just browse through all the schemes presented. So you can just see. If I talk about the first one is SBI Focused Equity Fund. Let's see. It is showing that moderately high. What is this moderately high indicating? It is indicating the risk level. So if your risk involved in this fund is low, moderate or high, it would be indicated very clearly by this meter, which is showing that the risk involved is moderately high. Here you can also see that it is long-term capital appreciation. The investment would be in equity and equity related instruments with maximum 30 stocks. As you can see, the whole of the investment is going in the equity stocks. This is why it is a moderately high risk is involved. When we talk about the equity stocks, we know that as compared to debt stocks, as compared to debt instruments, these contains a higher level of risk. So that is why it is showing moderately high risk level. So if you are ready to take risk, and looking at the return percent, you can go for this fund. Let me show you. And this is the return percent showing over here, 19.37%. But just have a look that this is return since inception. So inception is when this fund began. So you don't have to look for this return percentage. You can just, if you are interested in this kind, this scheme, you can just click over this scheme. And you can have a detail about the scheme. If you find it going well with your risk appetite with your return percentage expected, you can just click on that scheme and you can have a look at the return percent which you want. So here you can see in return section, you can just have a look at the 1 year return percent or 3 year return percent. So just click over it and you can see that the return percent over here has changed to -2.52%. So this is basically with most of the mutual fund schemes. In shorter period of time, you would be gaining no benefits. So an advice also that if you are investing in any mutual fund scheme, please wait and invest for more than 3 years or 5 years to see the actual benefit coming out of the scheme, or else it won't be much beneficial because it is subject to volatility in the market, and thus it involves a kind of risk in it. You can see in 5 years time period, you can avail the return percentage of 18.75%. So you can see the difference because of the time period. While we were seeing in 1 year of time, it was giving us negative percent, while in 5 years of time, it is providing 18.75% of return. And you can invest in a lump sum amount as well, which is 5,000, and in multiples, or an additional lump sum which you can pay in between is 1,000, or you can just choose for a SIP scheme depending on your choice. Now just have a look over here. Here is the details given about the fund manager. So if you have chosen this scheme, which is the equity scheme, it is providing you the details about the fund manager who would be managing your money, who would be managing your investment. So you can have a look over here and you can read about the fund manager and try to understand how well he is in managing the funds. So you can just have a detailed description of the fund manager over here, how much time period of experience he is having, what are all the funds he has been holding and how he managed. The total experience is given 26 years. The open-ended funds managed by Mr. R. Srinivasan has been given SBI Equity Hybrid Fund, Focused Equity Fund, Small Cap Fund. So you can just have a look at your fund manager's description as well. So it makes it more comfortable for you to choose whether to invest or not. Okay, so if you have also to know about the exit load. Exit load is when you want to get out of the scheme, what would be the percentage charged upon you. So you can see for exit within 1 year from the date of allotment, it would be 1%. So if you are exiting before 1 year, you would be charged 1% of interest. While if you are exiting after 1 year, there would be no charges. So this is exit load, which you can also consider. And let us have a look at the other schemes as well. So this is how you can choose. This was just an example of one of the scheme. This is how you can choose any of the scheme depending upon your choice. So this was about the equity fund, which was moderately high risk involving. Let me show you other funds as well. So these are all the funds which you can invest in. If I talk about my investment, I have done an SBI Nifty Index Fund, which I found to be useful because what it does, it is passive investment in stocks comprising the Nifty 50 index. So as the Nifty trends goes on, it follows a similar pattern. So it is like you can track the Nifty data and get an idea about how your fund is going. So this I feel is a better fund to be invested upon. And you can also go for SBI Blue Chip Fund. I would recommend because it has been one of the most successful fund schemes. Whether I talk about SBI or any other branches, any other banks, they also provide Blue Chip Funds. Blue Chip Funds mainly do investment in equity and equity related instruments of large cap companies. So these large cap companies are well established companies. So there is a little bit less risk involved as compared to the small cap companies, the startup companies. And thus you can depend upon the blue chip fund where your money is being invested in some of the top companies with large capitalization values. Well, these were all about the equity funds, and these funds were involving some kind of moderately high risk, as you can see. But if you don't want to, if you are a risk averse kind of investor, if you don't want to go with so much of risk, you can choose other funds as well, which is having moderate risk. You can see over here SBI Credit Risk Fund, SBI Magnum Guild Fund, SBI Banking and PSU Fund. All these funds are providing moderate risk level. And this would be investing in debt instruments. Okay, so you can see in description over here, it has been written that investment in debt instruments predominantly issued by banks, PSUs, PFIs and municipal bodies. So here the return percent would be a little bit lower, but you know, you would be assured that you would be involving a less risk over here because your fund is being invested in the debt instruments, which is highly secured, and thus you can really be reliable on this kind of investment strategies. And if you are a really risk averse person, you can also go for a very low risk involving funds, which you can see here is SBI Liquid Fund, which is involving a very low risk. And this is usually done for a shorter period of time. Investment is done in money market securities, like the maturity of which lies up to 91 days only. So you would get a regular income for a shorter time period. So whatever fund you choose, you can have a look at the risk involved. You can have a look at the percentage, the return percentage which you could be getting. And as I said, don't go for the inception date of risk, the return percent. Just click on any of the fund and then go to calculate the return percent for 1 year, 5 years, 10 years, whatever would be your choice, as I show you in the first fund scheme. So this is how you can choose for your mutual fund scheme, depending upon your choice, how much risk you are ready to get in, how much return you are expecting, and for what time period you wanted to hold that fund to. So you can just visit this website and you can get all the informations. And likewise, I am very sure if you are you wanted to invest in any other bank or any other brokerage firm, you can just go to their websites and you can consider all these schemes by properly analyzing and trying to coordinate it with your risking ability, with your return expecting conditions. So thus you can, and your investment ability, how much you want to invest in what schemes in what time period. And thus you can choose the best scheme possible for yourself